Today we're going to talk about Laravel service providers. I will show you with a practical example how we can create, register, and use a custom service provider in your application. Hey guys, I'm Dan and this is PixelFix, and I'm here today to hopefully help you understand the Laravel service provider just a little bit better. If you like these kinds of videos, please hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications so you don't miss out if I upload more content like this. If you have a specific problem or question, you're welcome to leave a comment down below, or you can join our private Facebook group, which I'll leave a link in the description for. Okay, let's go ahead and jump straight in. When an application grows, there's going to be a need to store your application configuration somewhere. Well, most likely it'll be in a database. And then you need some way of extracting that into a simple to access or easy to access way. And we're going to do this by implementing a service provider. Okay, so I've gone ahead and set up the migration for our setting table, which is basically a two-column table with a key-value pair. I've also gone ahead and set up the setting model and added the key value to the fillable properties. Okay, so let's go ahead and create our actual service provider by calling php artisan make provider, and we'll call it setting service provider. Okay, so next we need to tell Laravel to load our service provider on application boot. And we do this by registering it in the app configuration, which you can find under config app. And then we scroll down to the bottom where we find the section that says providers. Then you'll see the first section is the Laravel framework service providers. Then you've got your application service providers. And then at the bottom, we'll just add a new section that says custom service providers. And we just basically add our service provider. We just basically add our service provider to this array. Okay, so let's go ahead and configure our service provider. So if you open up your service provider, you'll see it's got two methods by default, register and boot. Okay, so the register method gets executed before the boot method, and within the whole boot process, all the register methods gets executed first, and then all the boot methods gets executed. And that is why you should never execute code in the register method that relies on another service provider, because you're not guaranteed that that service provider is available when your code gets executed. And that is why we're going to execute our code within the boot method of our service provider. When we load our configuration from the database, we would want to access it via the global config helper. For example, we want to call settings, and then we would want to set the, or read the, let's say, default from email address. Okay, so all that we need to do is to use the global config helper, then call the set method on it. And the first parameter we're going to pass is the key that we want to set, and in our case would be settings. And the second parameter would be the array or the data we want to call from the database. So we'll call the setting model. And then on the setting model, we're going to pluck the relevant information, which would then be the key column followed by the value column, and we want all the records in the database. So something to keep in mind here is all the service provider code gets executed before the migrations. So if you have to move this project to a new server, or you, for some reason, you need to rerun all your migrations, you are going to get an error, and I'll show you exactly what the error is. Okay, so if we go ahead and run our migration, you'll see that we get this error that says the base table or view settings cannot be found. Now, this is because Laravel executes the service provider code before it runs the migration. Okay, so the way around it is to basically wrap our line of code in a simple if statement. And what we're going to do is we're going to ask the schema if it has a table called settings. And then if that is true, then we're going to execute this code. Let's just clean this up. And now let's rerun our migrations and see if it works. Migrate, fresh. And there we go. All our migrations ran successfully. Okay, so now to see this in action, I've gone ahead and created a simple test. Now, this is just because it's fairly easy to run PHP unit and get a data dump from a test than it is to run something from a web interface. Okay, so now because we've loaded our application config into the global config helper, we can simply go ahead and die and dump our global config helper with the settings key. And if we run PHP unit again, we can see that it dumped out the settings I added earlier. But I just noticed these settings are not completely right. That is because in the settings service provider, I've got these two keys the wrong way around. So the first one should be the value, and the second one should be the key. And I'm pretty sure all of you saw that. Let's try this again. Run PHP unit, and now it should be right. So the default from is the admin email, and weekdays and whatnot. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it, and I really hope this episode helped you understand the Laravel service provider just a little bit easier. If you like this video or if you found it useful, please click the like button. Also, consider subscribing and hit the notifications icon so you don't miss out when I upload more content like this. Until the next episode, guys. See you later.